Okay, we are at the session two of this painting. So last night I got the tone of the paper set. Like, there's an evening scene, there's a nice pinkish purplish hue, and there's a sunset going on. This is a beach scene. And as you can see, right here, this is a very, very busy foreground. Like, I have people sitting on the table. There's a small shack, a flagpole, and there's a restaurant that says beach something. And I need to do this part, which is, I think, the most important part. And then I need to do all these tall trees that I have. So there are two ways I can do it. Either I can just go transparent and paint on top of that, or I can do negative painting around the figures and the tables and the shack and all of that. So I'm not sure which way I want to do it. Both are possible. I don't know which one will come out better, but maybe some of these places where I do not have a lot of things going on, I'll just paint over and do a little bit of negative painting around other people and on the people at the table. The benefit of the negative painting is I'll be able to save some of this yellow hue that will look like light reflecting from their clothes, or the evening light reflecting off them, or from the table. So I think I'll mostly lean towards negative painting and a little bit of paint, transparent painting over it. So let's start first with painting the trees in the horizon. I'll use a little bit of greenish tint, very light, and some orangish color. So what I'm gonna do most likely is just try to do the horizon here. There's some stuff there at the far distance. These could be trees, mostly trees, I think. And as it gets towards this, restaurant, it gets a bit darker. And there'll be other palm trees on top of it that'll come later. But for now, I'll use a little sharper brush, a more pointed one, and start putting in some green color to make look like we have a mix of yellow and green going on there. Okay. This part is going to be a little bit more dark. Help it transition. And now I'm going to use Burn sienna and looks messy right now, but give it some time and hopefully it'll turn around. is killing me. Just dab it a little bit to give it the tint, yellowish and orangish tint. Let's do this. We're going to have a little dark side here. Okay. There's some people sitting over there. And here. Okay. Okay. Maybe another one here. Maybe another here. Okay. Okay. Now let's fix the tables. And here it's going to be super dark. Okay. Okay, let's put a coat on this guy. Maybe a brown coat. Yes, I need some hair. Okay, I'm still lost. I don't have a very good feeling that I'll be able to complete this painting, but let's see. Okay, let's put on a coat on that one. Let's go with some blue. Something like let's put a face on him. Okay, this is gonna need a lot of fixing. As I'm not so far happy with. Okay, still. At this point, I'm not painting a specific item, but I'm going after whatever I see needs a little fixing. Okay. Now. What is this color? Nice yellowish. Okay. Okay, what else can we fix here? It looks too empty, it's not that busy. Okay, this needs. There's a. Over there. And here. Let's put a face on this guy. Now, how do you make that blue color pop? Just add a little bit of white to it. Now, let's do some black magic. Another person, maybe wearing something like grayish. Where does the table end? Okay, let's give him a face. Nice. Okay. Okay, and maybe we'll lighten this up a little bit so I can go super dark there. Okay, and big bench here. Okay, now we have a guy here. Bringing something on the table. Now let's give him an apron and first let's give him a face. And the scene still it still feels a little empty. So I may have to okay, and I have some people sitting over here. Okay. At this point, I'm just painting whatever I can see. Shack was supposed to be something like this. And let's just take some back. It's gonna be a lot of dry brush stroke. I might need some stuff here on the table. That table looks empty. Maybe let's put something here. Let's give them something to eat. Let's give them something here. Okay. Not feeling well. Okay, and what else we needed? Okay, we needed some more stools in this area. Stools, bar stools, some other stuff. I don't know what that is. There is something. Maybe some chairs here. Okay, do we need something on the table? I think we do. And there's something on the plate. And there's some smaller things. Doesn't look good. Okay, looks a little bit busy now. So we need a trash can. Somewhere on the beach. Let me put it here, maybe. Okay, and what else we want? We want some things in the distance, like a pier or something. Okay, now it's looking a little bit better, but not super happy. Let's do some more stuff here. Okay, well, this thing should be actually done in Orange. As you know. Okay. Okay. The stainless empty. Something here. Some of these things can be this. Not everything has to be black. Now it's looking slightly better, but still the things look a bit disconnected. I don't know why. Okay, now we're gonna have to paint those trees, and I'll probably come back later and see what I can adjust in the foreground. I'm not able to think right now, so it's better to step away a little bit and come back to it when I'm ready. Okay, so there's one of the trees. Okay, here we need another one. Okay, and like I mentioned earlier, so we're gonna have some darker trees here. That place is too dry. No, it's too wet. Okay, and this place I want to be a little bit darker. Well, not that dark, but so next is going to be some trees here. Okay, ox dogs. What next? Like I said, I'm just painting randomly right now. Like wherever I think something is missing, I'm just adding it. Okay. Okay, and I think I just need it. Yeah, give them some stripes, make it look interesting. Okay, let's now move on to the trees. Maybe I can do it like this. Something here. Okay, time to move on to the next one. I think I need more greens. I have a very strong feeling I have to come back and do something with the foreground again, but we'll see. Okay, so this is going to be a big giant blob. Way up in the sky and you can't see much, but and it's going to be super dark too. I'm just trying to get the overall shape correct at this point, not worried about how the leaves are spreading out, just getting the overall shape correct. I'm going to come in with my okay, more or less that's how it is. Okay, now I'm going to come in with some gray color because it's an evening scene and you can't see the green so clearly. So we need some gray to make it darker. Okay, now I'm gonna do the leaves. Some dry brushing. We already have enough paint on the paper, so we don't need more. So this is the tallest tree that is going to come like this all the way till here. Some more dry brushing. And what else? Okay. Okay. Okay, let's try to do the main tree now. Load it up with more paint. Planning to use mostly gray color. Well, that came down way too below, so hopefully we can fix that. Might as well do all the trees at the same time, that way I don't have to switch colors on my brush. Okay, next one is over here. Okay, the next one is somewhere. And that should be okay. It looks slightly fuller than before, but I think once I draw some more flags and stuff on the beach and all that stuff, it's gonna look better, hopefully. But let's see. Okay, time to get some greens going. And okay, this one is a big mess, as it appears. Almost dry brush, not exactly dry. I do have some paint in it, but so it goes. It's somehow merged into the other tree that we have. This is more or less how it's going to be. Okay, now let's do some finer details on the leaves, like how you would really see them. And let's get them all connected. Okay. Okay. All right, we're close. Those old trees that tree leaves that were chopped off at some point. And we need to do those. Okay, we are very close now. Like to do a few hanging ones from here. It's kind of looking nice from there. Okay, all right. Now we need okay, and there is a white color fence. Need, let me see if we can. We don't want the fence to be super bright, so I have it toned down a bit. Just to give a slight hint of the fence. You see, this kind of fence is very frequently on the beach, a white color fence. Okay, I'm not extremely happy with this, but well, this is what we got right now to work with. And I strongly feel at this point I should give it a break and come back to it later with some fresh ideas and see how I can get rid of the emptiness. If you guys are watching it and you think you have a solution, or you can point out the mistakes or how I could have done this painting differently, don't hesitate to leave a comment and let me know what went wrong. Okay, I'm gonna give it a break . Okay. All right, see you in the next painting.